Hi, I'm Lynn Whitesell, and welcome to the Excellence in Leadership series. Are you a successful leader? Would you like to be even more successful? Well, here are a few of the common beliefs that we've had clients share with us in coaching, and beliefs like these can, and they will, limit your success. Do you have thoughts like, I am successful because of my behaviors? Or, I don't want to involve others in my development because that would only point out my weaknesses? Do you think that executive coaching is only for leaders who are failing and not leaders like you who are succeeding? Well, here's the actual truth regarding these assumptions. Sometimes success comes in spite of your behaviors. Your weaknesses, well, they're already very apparent to others, and making a transparent commitment to do better, well, that can be very powerful. And executive coaching, it's for all leaders who want to be even more successful. Many leaders have found that the answer to replacing these limiting beliefs with empowering beliefs begins with coaching. Now, I know that in times past, executive coaching was often considered a last-ditch effort to save a leader before you walked them out the door. But now, much more often than not, executive coaching is for successful executives who desire to step up their effectiveness, and managers who are transitioning into newly appointed leadership roles, and for emerging talent who are being groomed for succession. The coach's role is to help these leaders identify the key behavioral changes that will make the biggest positive impact in increasing their leadership effectiveness, and help them see and minimize potential obstacles which can cause them to derail or go off the track. This often includes exploring deeply held limiting beliefs and behaviors. You can probably think of a time when there was a very successful it person at work, the person getting all the plum assignments, getting all the projects that maybe you wanted, getting the quick promotions, being held up as an example. There was lots and lots of buzz about this person until one day, well, there just wasn't, and you realize you hadn't heard from or about them in quite a while. They may even have been terminated, and you probably thought, what happened? Well, the answer may lie in this reality. The more successful we become, the more positive reinforcement we get, and the more likely we are to suffer from what Dr. Marshall Goldsmith, the world's number one executive coach, has coined the success delusion. Or as he puts it, I behave this way. I am successful. Therefore, I am successful because I behave this way. As a matter of fact, though, the more successful you are, the more delusional you may become as you buy into the surrounding hype. In reality, every leader has an area or areas where improvement would be beneficial. We start every day with the desire to be successful. I know that I do. How often, at the end of the day, were you not as successful as you had hoped to be or had planned to be? Even very successful people may be held back by an erroneous assumption about their own capabilities or a personal failing or two. You may be wondering, how do I avoid this success delusion and become even more successful? Well, you can begin with 360 feedback. This allows you to stop and listen and think about what others are seeing in you. 360-degree feedback starts with an assessment of your work behaviors. Stakeholders, including your bosses and your peers and your employees and others, and complete an online survey to rate you on a number of top pressing behavioral competencies as they are observed on the job. Then the data are compiled and the results of the survey are shared with you. And this allows you to see how you're viewed by others. Not surprisingly, stakeholder perspectives often differ from your own perspective, sometimes significantly, and this is very important for you to know. 360-degree feedback gives leaders insights into the areas they need to develop in order to remain successful in the future. And it typically provides a stimulus for change. For this reason, executive coaching often begins with 360-degree feedback. During the coaching process, the coach helps the leader hone in on the one or two behavioral changes on which to focus and to map out that action plan for achieving that change. Now, as I began to talk, you may have been thinking, how or even why does one go about helping a successful leader become even more successful? Surely it's enough for the leader to continue doing what he or she's always done because it's obviously working, right? Well, wrong. In order to stay successful in today's competitive business environment, leaders must be aware of any potential behaviors that could become career stallers. 360-degree feedback and executive coaching are tools that, when used appropriately and facilitated by experienced and certified professionals, can help successful leaders and their teams become even more successful and ultimately maximize leadership excellence and business results for their organizations. Thank you for taking the time to learn more about how successful leaders become even more successful through 360-degree feedback and executive coaching.